In 2002,
I was arrested.
I was sentenced to serve 16 years behind bars.
Serving life imprisonment and 20 years.
I'm a prisoner serving 20 years imprisonment
with
male prisoner serving the death sentence in this prison. My name is Clive Jacobson, and since 2002, I've been writing to mainly condemned inmates in Zambia, South Africa and Thailand. I spent some months in jail in the mid-60s, and ever since I've had a feeling for, well, how do current inmates, how do they handle it, and what could I possibly do to help? Out of the blue in 2002, a letter came from a Christian organisation asking if I would volunteer to write to one or more inmates in Zambia. And so I wrote to three. That three become 4, 5, 10, 20, 50, 100, 500. And I'm currently up to about 567. Now I've probably got over 2,500 letters. I realised I had to get some sort of order into my system. This is how I organise myself, because without organisation, doing this is just not going to work. I write out one page per inmate, which tells you what prison, in which country it is, so I can keep tabs on where they are, how I can track them down. I got a plastic sleeve for each inmate, put his name there, and I just fill up that plastic bag. And that goes in alphabetical order, write his name on the front. Now that's just a simple, workable system. I am Chota Makasa. Now I'm in the prison because I've broken the law by doing the hijacking, possession of firearm and ammunition. Here in South Africa, lots of people are unemployed and many families are struggling in their homes because of poverty. So I've done this terrible thing to think that I will get something for my family, but I did not succeed. For the inmates, it's the only form of communication is the written letter. And many of them have said that they just love getting communication from anyone, anywhere, and so few of them do. Many of them, the whole family has just abandoned them. They don't want nothing more to do with them. And to get a letter from someone, they crave that because it reminds them of contact that they would normally or could have outside. And yes, they love that. The kind of crimes, anything from rape to stealing a cow, stealing a loaf of bread, stealing vegetables. Several of the inmates who've written to me and said that they stole a small amount of food, and they're in there for 10, 15, 18 years. It's really a shocking condition. I'll normally buy email envelopes, say, once every month or two. I'll take those, thank you. MR's quite expensive internationally, so I could spend $100 to $200 a month in the peak of it. In 2008, I was sentenced into imprisonment to jail to serve 16 years behind bars. And this matter affected my wife, and on the same day of my judgment, she decided to kill herself by throwing herself under the big bus that was coming ahead. Yeah, I've forgotten that one. Many years since I read that. My letter writing is done on a train to Shell Harbour, which is a 4-hour train journey.
Right. And I thank you.
So I take the letters I want to answer, walk down to the station, get on the train into the city, and sit down, open my writing kit, and away I go. I could spend up to 11, 12, 13 hours a month in letter writing. My name is Crispin Muke. I was sentenced to death by hanging by the High Court. I was married before I was jailed. We were blessed with four children. My wife died while I was in police cells.
So my children are suffering like orphans. It is only the grace of God which has kept them alive up to this day. You do get close to them and you get to know their likes and their dislikes. What do I think about them? I don't judge them. They can't undo the crime they've done. No one can. But no one is beyond redemption.
Doors closing. Please stand clear.
My Christian outlook is forgiveness. And if I can help you in some way to survive, to make good in life, then I'll do it if I can.